Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about important aspect is complexity. So we are writing a code for factorial, for Fibonacci, maybe for validation of expression or iterating onto array, writing a matrix using 2D array, all these basic things, right? What is important? If we are writing a simple 5 factorial, then we know, okay, this is going to take this many milliseconds. What happens if you are writing a factorial of 1000 or 5000, okay? If you are getting the Fibonacci series of 1 lakh, right? Okay, so in this particular case, what is going to come into the picture is the complexity. Once the data size increase, earlier you have only 5 elements in array and you are doing search. So it will take less amount of time, some fraction of milliseconds, right? Now if the data is thousands of in the data properties there in the array, now you are doing search for an element. So how the memory space-time complexity increase in this particular case? And we are going to analyze that based on the big O notation. This you might have studied in your college education, or big O, omega, theta, different notations. We are talking big O only, like how to evaluate the complexity of a particular algorithm. So that is denoted using on, on square, on log n, on cube, based on how your graph proceeds when we compare the time and the data. So if you see this, size of the data means size of the input, and the time to complete that execution, okay? And you can see sometimes it's linear. Whatever your input is, it's going to return the same time. You see, on is linear, log n, it means that whenever your input size is increasing, time is comparatively same. But when you talk about n log n, it is, you can see the 45 degree. It means when you are increasing the input data, time is also increasing. N is square, it is increasing with the twice, twofold, two to power n. Okay, these are different graphs shown here, and there is a respective algorithms also for them. We'll talk about them, like O1, right? No matter what you provide as input, it is going to return you output in 1 second. So the time is constant, data you keep increasing, but the time is constant. So that is a O1 complexity. We'll talk about example on this. And the entire thing we are denoting using big O notation. So big O notation is to be able to compare how efficiently one algorithm solves big problems compared to another, right? And we are checking the performance of algorithm based on the, by increasing the data with the time, okay? Similarly, we have like these different algorithms, binary search, quick sort, bubble sort, or binary tree, traversal, and all, right? So on is here we are talking about, I think, and log n, binary search, okay? And if you have unsorted list and you are doing search, then it will take a on linear. I mean, for one item it is taking 1 second, for 10 item it will take 10 seconds. We are taking a look at the worst case. Consider that whatever the element you are searching is at the last index, okay? So if you have 100 elements and for one element search or one iteration it is taking 1 second, then it means it will take 100 seconds. So it is on based on the data input size, time will also increase. Binary search is a divide and conquer. So what it does, it divides the number of elements in which you are going to search. In every iteration it is reducing it to half, so it is better than on, it is log n. So you can see these different charts for different algorithms. You can see we can evaluate them, right? What is best? O1, you increase the data, time is going to remain same, so that is best. Log n, binary search, still better. On, fair. But when you keep n log n, n square, n cube, n to the power 4, it is worst, right? Because with the increase of data, time has increased 4 folds 3 folds, right? Simple example, this. Whatever the input you provide, it will take same amount of time to just evaluate what is even and what is odd, right? Simple complexity, it is O1. Now this is, what you are doing is you are running a loop and then checking what is the max. So what do you think about this? So find max. you still have to iterate to, if there are 20 elements you wanted to find maximum out of it, consider that the maximum element is sitting at the end of the array. So it will take on, and it will increase linearly with the 45 degree graph. And this is, you are running two different loops, a loop inside loop. So if outer loop is doing an iteration for one single iteration, inner loop is doing an iteration again. So it is automatically n square. Similarly, n cube and n log n and all. And log n will introduce whenever you are actually doing a divide and conquer like binary search. In the first iteration, you will know that element will be there in the first half or second half. So in every iteration, you are reducing the number of elements by 2. I mean, reducing it to 50%. So your searching effort are getting reduced. So that's why it is a log n. Okay, we can see the different complexities for the different cases: worst case, best case, average case. Worst case means the elements are scattered. For right. So we have a bubble sort. So we always talk mostly about the worst case because we are taking edge case. Okay, what if your data is in the worst case? Okay, so these are big O notations. This is how we evaluated time complexity and space complexity. And okay, we have a lot of different data structures: array, stack, queues, singly, doubly, linked list, binary search tree, which is log n, okay, B tree, Redback tree, AVL tree. These are just for notation numbers. If you can remember, that is fine. Otherwise, you already know what is log n, what is n log n, what is n square, n cube. Okay, so that's it about big O notations and space time complexity. Thanks everyone.